Hello everyone, it's Rémi from Softron, and in today's video, an introduction to MovieRecorder, all the features available, how to get started, and to do that, we only need one Mac. So let's do this. Two versions of MovieRecorder, the classic one and MovieRecorder Express, which is the entry-level version of the software with less features, less codecs. Differences are on the website, but here we are gonna focus on the classic version. Here you can see the user interface with one source already detected. The list is available on your left. Local sources from video cards automatically detected on your Mac. We are talking about Blackmagic, AGA, DeltaCast. We also support NDI and remote control sources. Sources that you can control remotely and record directly on the Mac where it is located. But technically, we are not doing any of that right now. What you can see is a signal from OnTheAir Video, a playout solution we have here in Softron. It is currently running on the same Mac with the direct link feature we created, and I don't even need to use a video card, so I can work with ingest and playout only using that Mac. Coming back to MovieRecorder, we will now set the recording by creating a destination. We are using MXF and QuickTime wrappers. For both, you are seeing now all the codecs available. Set and done, I'll just drag and drop the destination on the source, click on record, and that's it. The file is currently growing on my local storage. We are using Apple ProRes, but if I would like some backup, for example, on another storage like a NAS, well, it is possible. That same source recorded on multiple destinations at the same time, H.264 QuickTime, AVC Intra, all stored in different folders, and I can go even further. AV presets, where we can add effects, overlays, audio mapping, iframe rates, HDR, SD, up to 8K formats, and we can do a lot of different things. And because I'm a very busy guy, we can schedule the recordings. As you can see here, I have added more sources, and I will automatically schedule a 30 minutes recording at, let's say, 2 p.m. and select why not the second source, record, and let's go. Now, if I want to do some editing, maybe I can use the file while it is recording and use it on multiple software such as Final Cut, Premiere Pro that you see right now, but also Avid and Resolve. But every time the configuration depends on the app, so I suggest you visit our website where you can find a lot of interesting information. Here you can see our usual manual for MovieRecorder with more advanced features, GPI triggers, closed captioning, and how to use the Stream Deck to control MovieRecorder, why not? And there are a lot of other features that you can discover, 7 resource configuration, VTR batch control, timecode sources, metadata, well, you name it, everything is on our website. The link is down below. Don't hesitate to contact us here in Softron, and I'll see you in the next video.